at the museum for the second day. We're about to set off to the petrol hedonism event, and we're deciding what cars that we're going to be taking down. So there'll be a nice convoy to the event. There's something very special, this trailer just behind me here, which we'll have a quick look at before we do set off.
There in
we
here, go. In here.
We just opened it up, nothing.
Yeah, imagine it's already been
taken
out.
Should we do it?
Yeah, let's get it out.
I say we, but by that I mean yeah. Tony.
Yeah, we'll get Tony to do it.
Oh. Wow, that's a unicorn. You know, yes. The phrase is bandied around when it comes to hypercars quite often, because there's a lot of really rare stuff out there, but that's something that if you asked me, did I ever think I would see here, the answer was no. And the owner of this car is a legend with some amazing cars that I've been lucky to drive. And to see this here now is like, just, it's ridiculous.
For me, it was a dream come true as well. Well, I've been lucky enough to pretty much transport everything in this room.
Yeah.
To get the call to transport something like that, childhood just...
Doesn't happen.
Doesn't happen.
That is absolutely crazy.
And obviously, it's in the trailer at the moment, but we'll get out when we're at the event.
Yeah, when we're at the event. Just gonna... So I do hope it was worth the wait.
918, more on that later. GT Black Series.
He was right about the GTA. That startup sound is very loud. I'm sat in the car with Mark. We're in the GT Black Series.
On our way to Petrol Hedonism.
Yeah, and we've just seen a very special convoy of cars with us behind.
Never see those together on the road.
No,
never.
No.
How often would you see that? I've seen them many times static, like standing still.
Yeah.
But I've never seen them together in one, you know, driving together on the road.
No. Oh, that was cool to see both of them. I think this is the first time I've been in the Black Series. Tom used to have one. Tim has done it properly with this one because it actually sounds decent.
Yeah, and 32,000 miles on absolutely 32.
On a Black Series, the highest mileage Black Series.
Must be.
The bars are in the way, but you can just about make out what's behind us.
There's a third one as well.
Is there?
Yeah, it's comparison to see the difference in size.
Look at the size of that. It's huge.
It's carnage, isn't it? When we pulled out and saw them joining the same road, it's like, what?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah.
You don't, I mean, that must be like the only 6x6 in the country, the only land layer in the country.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's another one of either. Clearly heading where we're heading.
Yes.
Which makes it even better. So we've gone from a, let's say, 4-car convoy plus Tony and the trailer behind somewhere to adding two more.
Very nice. It makes the G-Wagon look like a baby. So I'm all the way down in London, and what are the chances? One of my friends has just given me a ring to say, have you just gone past? Was you in the GT Black Series with Shmee and the other fleet of cars? And I was like, yeah. So what are the chances that on a random Friday, my friend passes us going the other way? Yeah, weird. He'll appreciate that I've given him a little shout out as well. Tim's arrived in his section. It was a good convoy down here. We got some somewhat decent shots. Obviously, travelling through London at this time is a bit of a nightmare. It's hard to stay all together. Black Series, it sounds so much better, especially now with the exhaust, which is how it should sound from factory. And then this, to say that it is the V6, it does sound okay, but again, it's definitely not as loud as this thing. Tim and I have just finished our little walk around that we did with the 918, which you can watch in his video. All that's left to do now is
get all these lovely cars, the additional lovely cars that we're taking down with us. So we've got 1M, 675LT, and then the Zenvo is also going down. We're going to move this into the trailer.
It's go time!
So the car is now in the trailer. How do you think I did, Brad?
You did pretty well, to be fair. I'm hoping that my filming was good.
Oh, I'm sure it will be. The fuel coming from that car.
Same.
This is a very good camera car to have because you can have the window down, the roof is off, you can point it elsewhere.
I'm glad to be your camera car driver.
Yes, and this is the first time I've ever been in a 675 LT as
well. Enjoying it so far?
Loving it. The seats, I think these are the P1 seats, if I'm right, and they're very tight. I've got used to them now, I've kind of like...
You could get them in two sizes, so I think this is the medium, smaller one. They're bigger ones, but yeah, they're quite snug.
But I'm not complaining because of the car that I'm in. We've got the 1M next to us, and then this is just shooting some mad flames out of the back of it. Arriving now into the car park. What an entrance with the two purple cars though. I could literally feel you've got your ears covered.
I wanted to say something and I was like, I don't want you two having to beep it.
Oh my god, that is loud. When my hand was up there, I could feel the heat just hit my hands.
Yep.
That's wild.
That he drove further forwards because I was like, those flames are so long.
God, I mean, I expected it, but I didn't expect it. The Zenvo's in position, 296, the GT Black Series, the GTA, the 675LT, and then the 1M is all ready. And then all we need to do now is go and get the 918. It is going to be in this section with Tim's cars. The layout is 918 in the center, and then the two purples because we've got a P1 coming to join us, and then obviously the Zenvo is purple. That was a cool convoy down. Very cool convoy down. So aside from the Zenvo, another purple car's arrived. This time the P1, which is gonna be two-thirds of the Holy Trinity, which is gonna be here, and it's gonna be parked next to the 918. So it's gonna look good together. It'll be purple, purple, orange. Yeah, it does look good. Fully exposed purple carbon. So Tim's just doing his thing with the P1. He's just started it, so I might give him the key to the 918 to see if he wants to start that. Just so then he can do all three that way. Now I can show you actually that they're all lined up, all on the plinths. Finally made it, Tim.
We did.
The cars are all on the plinths.
It's gone successfully, hasn't it?
Yeah, it did actually. It went better than what I was expecting.
These are all looking beautiful on the stands together here.
Yes, they are. They really are.
Mission success. We've got a lovely colour distribution.
Oh God, it's very bright.
It's looking really nice.
It's nice to be surrounded by two purple cars.
Yeah, I just feel bad that I don't have a LaFerrari here because that would be the Holy Trinity.
The Holy Trinity, yeah. That's about.
I better go buy a LaFerrari. Let me see if I can get one by tomorrow.
That's what he has to do now. You've said it now. can't even put a badge on it because it'll kick off.
Can you imagine if you put a Ferrari prancy horse on the front?
Oh my god, all hell would break loose.
No, we're not doing that.
No.
Hey, look, my Ferrari's here. My hybrid Ferrari is here.
Yeah, it's close enough.
We've done part way.
Yeah.
Epic though. It's been so cool having the 918 at the garage. And yeah. That's not the end.
No.
We've got some fun plans in the works.
Yeah, no, definitely. You'll have to stay tuned for those videos, but right, we're all tired. So we best get going.
See you later.
See ya.
This is the first time seeing inside the Zenvo.
God, look at all that carbon fibre.
Yeah, so Brad has very kindly opened the Zenvo for us. It's just covered in carbon fibre. I feel like I should open the bonnet of this one now, because that's got all carbon fibre, but that just trumps this one with carbon.
It's not quite the same, is it? Is that just storage in the front?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Whereas, I can show you storage in that, but it's just a lot more carbon fibre.
Oh, is there actually storage in there?
There is storage in there, yeah. It's just carbon fibre. You can't put much. You can maybe fit one or two soft bags.
Like a little helmet thing, like in the STO.
No, it's more than that. There isn't more than that.
So it's a practical car then?
Yeah, exactly that.
Somewhat practical.
Although I don't think it's the pretty thing just to open up and leave on display open. Whereas that's quite fun because engine, stupid amount of power, and obviously a lot of carbon fibre.
Do you want to see our engine?
Yes,
it's literally, it's pathetic, right?
Okay.
If you wanted to have a look at it, all it does is that pops open. So it goes boof. All you can see.
Is it pretty underneath? Is it carbon fibre?
No, literally, just the netting, like the mesh.
This mesh just opens up.
Oh, right.
So I can still see it anyway.
Yes, exactly.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Lovely. I've done this, but it would be so much more simple.
Actually, saying that, you can see through some of the holes on that and see through two bits.
How much carbon fibre would you like, sir?
Yes.
Everything. That is yes. It. It's like, yes. Give the me answer carbon is yes. Fiber. Driving here yesterday with it, an experience.
Well, see, I'm used to it, like I've seen it enough times.
Yeah.
But when you haven't been on the road with it and you see it, one, just driving anyway, because it doesn't, like, that shouldn't be a thing.
No.
Like, nothing should look like this.
No.
And then obviously you see these flames that must be this big on the back.
Yeah, they are huge. Yesterday when we pulled in, you got a good shot of that one, actually.
Yeah.
You got a really good shot. You'll have to look in the video this week's just done. Because pulling in, when you're in here, obviously everything echoes.
Everything is extremely loud in here, and then you put it in launch control, and it's just bang, bang, bang,
yes.
Boom, and a big old flame out the back.
I was putting my camera out of the window.
Did you miss
and
it?
No, I got it.
Okay.
And my hands felt like it were burnt. The little mic on top was like...
It does look a bit burnt on that.
In fact, you know what? This bit actually does, to be honest.
But that's the point.
Worth it, though.
That's
worth it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Can he get in? That is the question, though.
I don't know.
Now you're going to draw everybody's attention.
My bad.
We're just going to clickbait this whole video of like Shmi 150 banned from the petrol hedonism event.
I can't believe it.
I know.
Shmi 150 has been banned.
It's been banned. He's not allowed in. He's too popular at this point.
He has his meet and greet in, I think, 15 minutes.
15 minutes.
Yeah.
And we're a bit stuck.
We've not got long.
No. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the Shmi 150 effect.
Nobody knew he was coming.
But it's been flooded already. I've become very on brand with the 918 because look at the colour of the drink and then the colour of the car. So the car's unloaded into the trailer. Hopefully you can hear me because there is some people revving outside. But yes, the car is in the trailer. The hardest part is done. And now we're going out in convoy with the Shmi-mobiles. We've got the Zenvo, the 296, and then the 1M. They're all asking him to rev it. It won't be warm enough yet. That's what Adam C was talking about when he said that it's always the car spotters that is the biggest entertainment.
Yep. Hopefully.
Yeah. I'm filming now in case one of them falls. We've just dropped off the first lot of cars. We've come to pick up the 675 LT. I'm going in the GT8 for the first time, so it'll be nice to see how it compares to the GT12.
Mr. Shadow with Shmoo the cow. It's quite strange when you go from one car to another, right? Just driving the Zenvo, now we're driving in here.
Yeah.
Very, very, very different type of car.
Yes, both very loud cars.
Both very loud V8s.
Yes.
But in quite different ways. Manual right drive instead of left. But this thing, when we get it opened up, you will enjoy.
Yes.
It makes quite the racket.
Yes.
When it arrived, I remember the conversations from when the GT8 launched and when the first cars were being delivered.
Yeah.
Everyone was really surprised that it was louder. I haven't heard them side by side for 6 years, 7 years, so it's immediately in my mind. But I definitely remember people being like, dang, that GT8 thing is mad. This is with the valve open, so this guy called Clive from CC Charger came up with this just
it's just working on the relay, these Astons from this generation.
Super simple,
so you can have the valve, because otherwise it does this really horrible noise at about 3,500 RPM when it opens up, 4,000 RPM. So it doesn't change the noise when you're at the top of the rev range, it only changes the noise when you're at the bottom of the rev range. But anyway, it does the good noises, which you like from these things. In fact, what I used to do, and what most Aston owners of this generation Vantage do, and it changed, so I'm not going to quote the numbers, but in the fuse box, it's just pulling out one of the fuses that controls the valve. So you can do that in the GT12 as well.
Okay, yeah, that's good to know.
It's super simple. Or you can install a switch like this.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's 3,000 RPM.
And it still sounds like that.
It's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. It really is.
Look who it is. It's Turbo Transport.
Found Tony. It's finally arrived. He's got the Cessna to work. Oh no, he's giving us a wave.
The royal wave.
The little hand. Yeah. Yeah, it's a great sound. The best bit is, you know when you plant your foot and it's like the snap, it sort of like makes a weird like snap sound, but it's such a good sound. The downshifts on these are brilliant. Yeah. Manual is a good touch. People were saying, a lot of people were asking about if the GT12 is a manual.
Nope.
But, no.
Sport shift.
Yep.
Semi-automated.
Yes.
Basically automated manual. I mean, technically you could argue mechanically it's a manual.
Yeah.
Just the computer controls the clutch, not your left foot.
Yeah.
It's effectively the difference.
Yeah. It's better to have it in manual paddle shift mode.
Oh, you don't want
to
drive it in auto, do you?
No.
If you drive it in auto, it will always try and shift exactly when you don't want it to.
Yes.
I mean, the thing is, there was this era, right, of cars with that. The Ferrari F1 gearboxes.
Yeah.
So, you know, 360s, 430s, etc., etc., until they did the dual clutch in the 458. At the 599 has the F1. LFA, R8s, Vantages, 177.
Mm.
It was this era where that was the latest technology because they were lighter than dual clutches or automatics at the time, significantly. And obviously in a sports car, weight is very important. And they had faster shift times.
Yeah.
Certainly than you could do yourself, which at the end of the day is what a performance car should be about, right?
Oh, yeah.
Quickest possible acceleration and driving. So there was this era, and they're funny cars because you need to drive them with the mindset of a manual in terms of how you adapt the throttle pedal when you're shifting and do it manually. Don't let the car do it. It's not like a PDK or something in a brand new car now.
It's not all the technology that's just helping it.
Yeah, so you look at it and you think it should be a dual clutch or an automatic and you don't need to do it, but you have to drive it like it's got one of the, like there's a clutch pedal and a gear shifter that you need to be in charge of.
Mark and I were complaining. We were saying, God, the roads in this country are awful down here.
Yeah.
He's lucky in Germany, but the roads are pretty nice for him, he was saying.
And we've got the extended splitter on, but we're good. Yes. We worry about it anyway.
Yeah, and no front lift either.
No front lift at all.
Nope.
And somebody's going to try and come past us, but...
Like somebody itching to go around.
Yes. It's a 20 mile an hour zone. I'm going 20.
Yeah.
That's not 20.
Oh, and filming. Oh, God. If I'd have turned the camera around just
and
then.
And there's a police van as
police
well. Police
van.
Funny thing.
Filming. Yeah.
Filming while driving. Look at that. Okay, the camera didn't see that, but he went right lane and blasted across to the left. So he went round somebody here in the right lane.
And then joined on what, that
driving road. Standards today have been pretty atrocious.
Oh, yeah.
And it's funny to watch, because when you're in a convoy of cars like this,
yes,
you just have to take it slow and steady.
Oh, yeah.
You just have to expect idiots.
Yes.
Sorry to be so blunt about
it. Oh, no, it's true.
And you just make it work. Take it easy.
Yeah.
Slow and steady wins the race.
Yeah, because the amount of people when you was in the Zenvo,
yeah, I know,
were just weaving in and out on the phones and
it's so sketchy.
Yeah,
it's one of the reasons I don't tend to like driving supercars in the city.
No,
it's
city driving in supercars is one of the worst things that you can do. it's not the best.
Oh, whatever that is, we'll go around it.
God, I can't even tell what that actually is. Yeah, the roads today have been very questionable, especially on the drive back to go get the cars. That car is just, I don't actually know. The car, even the front of it, the bonnet was pretty much hanging off. Oh, there's some sights.
That feels like you're in Florida all of a sudden.
Yeah.
The UK shouldn't be like that.
No, not road legal. It just reminds me of that picture where it's like, I think it was like, bro, just give the car up. And it was barely like moving. It
stop
had no...
Stop trying to save it. It's done.
Yeah. finished the weekend. We're back at the Schmuseum. We finished the petrol hedonism event. The 918 is there, ready to be loaded for its next adventure. But we've got something very special here. And one of my friends sent a picture of his son's little model. And I'm going to get Tim to run us through the car because I won't do this car justice with the information he has. He will be so much better. So, Tim.
I'm not researched.
No.
We're just going with the flow.
We are literally, yes.
Lamborghini Sesto Elemento.
Yes.
One of 9 believed to be built.
Right.
It was going to be 20. It's probably a number between.
Yes.
999 kilos, based on the Gallardo. Remember, this is a couple of years before the Hurricane.
Yes.
So it kind of gives some Hurricane design in a way.
Yes.
Full carbon fiber body. This really quite cool weave. Very small exposed carbon fiber weave.
Yes.
The idea is stripping out every bit of weight possible. Look at the dashboard.
There is absolutely
what
nothing.
What dashboard?
Yeah, yeah.
What dashboard is the best way to describe it? V10, of course.
Yeah.
And I actually always quite like this nod to the 10 cylinders with the 10 hexagons.
Yeah, that's a good...
Familiar Lamborghini design. Hexagons, triangles. Those are your exhaust tailpipes.
Oh, God, yeah.
Sitting behind the wing uprights, which is kind of cool. By doing that means more airflow can be dealt with by the diffuser. Look at these shapes, though. Look at how everything's opened and cut away. I mean, the gearbox sits right here.
That's my...
It's track car rather than road car. Mm. This belongs to the Scotland Lamborghini collection.
Yes.
Amazing collection of cars.
Yes.
Really cool owner who's incredibly generous to allow this to be at the event for people to come along and see. Pop open the door and look at the way the mirrors are designed. It's just cool. And inside, full race car.
Oh, look at that. The interior is beautiful. Red and
it's
black.
Crazy to think this was one of the few off-series Lambos.
Yes.
14 years ago. And, I mean, just look at it, right? Just look at all this. Every detail. Just so cool.
God, look at that.
I'd love to pop out some scales and see what it actually weighs.
Yes.
I should have got some here for right now so we can test it. It's just mega. Absolutely mega.
It really is. And it's in this museum.
Yeah, which is also mega.
Yes, exactly.
We had to move my F1 show car.
Yeah.
There's quite a cool mix of cars around right
now. There actually is. Yeah. It's very nice. Well, thanks for doing this car justice with the knowledge, Tim.
Some knowledge, not every detail.
Yeah.
We'd have to wind back a little bit to get all the details, but definitely, definitely special. Just look at that's funny, it's like a finger gap.
Yeah.
Actually on road tyres.
The bolts are, yes, it actually is as well. It's just the little touches. Look at the window. And this has recently been on track as well, so the owner does use it.
And he's going to drive it a lot.
Yes.
It's very cool.
So I hope you enjoyed the video. It's been a very busy weekend. We haven't really
sporadic.
Stopped. Yes.
Random.
Yes. We've had two very nice, well, four actually, convoys to and from the event the multiple times in the very nice cars. The Zenvo is still...
Stupid.
Yes, with the flames that it shoots.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just a flamethrower, constantly throwing flames, but you can't complain. When you see it flying down the road, the looks that it was getting today on the drive home, because we set off at... Like, not rush hour, but sort of when
busy.
Most cars were leaving, especially on the roads. The looks it gets. We was trying to do some filming, but nobody was letting us in.
No, because everyone wants to tailgate it, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, to see all the flames and everything.
It's kind of terrifying driving something like that in city traffic.
Yeah, yeah.
Best suited to nice open roads to go and enjoy.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. You'll have to bring it up at some point.
Sounds like a plan.
Enjoy those roads up there. But yeah, it's been a great event. It's been really, really fun. Thanks for hosting it.
Pleasure.
Tom
Thanks for coming by. Thanks for joining.
No, it's all good. It's
your
all
place
good.
Next time.
Yes.
Up
yes.
to visit the Wambon.
Yes, you definitely need to come. So Tom and I are very thankful that you've allowed us to store the 918
Absolute
down here.
Absolute pleasure.
And I'm sure we'll see you at some point again down here with another car. We'll make sure it's a bright car. It has to be.
Yeah. None of this like satin grey, lucky colours.
Yeah.
No, who wants that?
It's too odd in here now. It's too odd. And we have to give a special shout out. So Tony, who is over there. Thank you for transporting it, Tony.
You're welcome.
Yes. And we will see you in the next video. Do your little cheers, Tim.
Cheers.
I love it.